Here we go. An Emmy nominee for this work in the assassination of Johnny Versace, American crime story. Now a new movie, Right When You Get Work, Finn Wittrock is here. Nice to see you this morning.
Good to see you guys.
You picked the right day. Please share with the class your in and out order.
Oh, double-double animal style.
Uh-huh. Good choice.
Very good. Yeah.
Nothing else to
go. Right, like, what else would you do?
I don't care if it's 8:45 right. in the morning.
No. When you go for it, you got to go for
That's
it.
That's right. Yeah.
Wonderful class picture here from the crew with the Johnny Versace project and having that Emmy. That must have been a fantastic night.
It was an amazing night, yeah. And I think I was here talking about a month or so ago.
Right.
And yeah, so it was nice to be celebrated in that way, you know, for a show that you believe in so much.
And then Ryan Murphy always does this thing with, I think, kind of a repertory company, essentially.
Exactly,
And you're on the list.
I am.
Do you know what's next?
No idea. He kind of keeps us guessing a little bit. Sometimes he'll put out an Instagram post saying, can't wait to work with this guy again, and you have no idea what he's talking about. But something really fancy and fun always comes.
Do you see people kissing up to him all the time because they want to be a part of that group?
Yeah, that happens. Yeah. I mean, but he's very loyal. I mean, like, he's kind of built an incredible group around him, and I think he enjoys kind of giving actors something new and challenging to do that they
And was there an initial introduction? How did you get into the universe to begin with?
I did a film called The Normal Heart.
Which was a terrific
on HBO.
Movie.
Yeah. And I from there he offered me his part on American Horror Story, sort of on the set one day.
Wow.
And that's sort of just how he rolls.
There, you know? Why not? Nothing wrong with that. This one, Right When You Get Work, is often a phrase I think that like parents say to their kids.
Yeah, right. When you get to the city, kid,
let us know what happens.
Yeah.
What's it about?
It's a heist movie disguised as a romantic comedy, and it's also got some social commentary thrown in there.
Okay.
It's a lot of stuff. I play a guy from the kind of wrong side of the tracks in the Bronx who has a lifelong love for this girl who has sort of left the Bronx and gone to this fancy Upper East Side Catholic girls' school and is sort of leading a double life, and so I start to sort of weasel my way into her life by some con artistry and some thievery and the usual.
The usual, nothing wrong with that. When you do an indie in New York, because there's a lot of great street scenes in New York, is that run and gun or do you?
Oh, it's hard.
Yeah.
People do not like when you take their parking spaces in New York.
No.
They don't care if George Clooney's in that movie, they'll be beeping and, you know, saying epithets to you all day long.
Another movie, I talked to Barry Jenkins about If Beale Street Could Talk, which is really a laudable thing. Talk about that project.
Amazing film. Barry Jenkins, who did Moonlight, and is just, this is a James Baldwin novel that is beautiful, heartbreaking, very, very, I think, on the pulse of the times right now. And just kind of, as you can see, sort of a visual feast.
And he talked to me about the language of James Baldwin and the sort of the NOLA language of James Baldwin and how it was very important to preserve that.
Yeah.
Did you have to speak in a different way?
No, it's just his novels are like long poems in a way.
They
just so lush with language, and so to sort of try to capture that in a naturalistic way is its own unique challenge. But he also plays with silence a lot. There are whole scenes where a lot happens and no one really says much of anything. So it's a really interesting, really powerful, quiet movie. I was just really honored to be a part of it.
How long have you been out here?
I'm pretty much from here. I lived in Glendale since I was like 12.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
So growing up here and the thought, I want to do all this.
Yeah.
And now you are doing all this.
Yeah.
Is it what you thought it would be?
It's a cool homecoming because I lived in New York a long time. I did a lot of theater. I did stuff in Chicago and all over the place, and sort of work over the years has sort of taken me back to LA. And I'm not leaving anytime soon.
There you go. And no reason to leave. Yeah. Right When You Get Work hits theaters November the 23rd. If Beale Street Could Talk hits theaters in mid-December on the 14th. Finn, you get your animal style burger.
I'm going.
Good to see you.
I'm here.
Thanks so much.
Thanks,
wait, hang on.
Very
good.
Enjoy.
Well done.
Wow. I'll just go over here, guys.
Yeah.
Okay.
No problem.
Look at that. Home delivery. Well done.
I'm coming back.
Yeah, please.
Thank you, Finn.